everyone, assalamualaikum. Welcome back to Dr. Teeth. Today I am here to talk about pyria, the causes, symptoms and its treatment. So whenever you think about gum disease, you might think of one condition, which is pyria, right? And if you are worried you might have that disease, you are probably looking for some answers. So here I am with this video, which outlines the causes, symptoms, prevention and management methods about this disease. For detailed information, stay tuned till the end of this video, and if you have any questions, you can comment below. So basically, there are two different types of gum diseases, gingivitis and periodontitis. Gingiva means the gums, and itis is a term for inflammation. So the term gingivitis literally means inflammation of the gums. If gingivitis is left untreated, it can advance to periodontitis. That is when your bones also get involved. So this inflammation in the gums become destructive in periodontitis. So pyria is nothing but advanced gum disease, more commonly called periodontitis. So let me begin by explaining what is pyria. As you all are aware, it is the most common dental problem we are facing today. Pyria is a severe infection of the gums. The term comes from the Greek language meaning discharge of the pus. In this condition, the tissue supporting and surrounding the teeth, that is the periodontium, is affected. And if this situation is left untreated, the patient will start losing his teeth. So you must be wondering what causes pyria. Many times people do not pay proper attention to the cleanliness of their teeth, and in such a situation, problems related to teeth start. Pyria is one of those problems. This occurs because of bacteria that have been allowed to increase in numbers because of poor oral hygiene. These severe infections can cause damage and destruction of the surrounding ligaments, gums, and bony structures if not treated at the correct time. If you talk about the bacterial aspect of it, there is a particular bacteria called Pyria alveolaris which causes this disease. So as the disease progresses, it leads to bleeding and pus discharge from the gums. Bleeding gums are a warning sign that should never be ignored. The simple fact is healthy gums don't bleed. So if your gums bleed, get it treated. So keeping this in mind, now I'd like to move on to the next part. What are the symptoms of pyria? Pyria can be identified by the following symptoms: smelly breath, red or swollen gums, bleeding gums, gums that become softer, pain when chewing anything, loosening of teeth, feeling of sensitivity in teeth, gums move inward and teeth appear longer. So if you ever experience any of these symptoms, you should immediately consult a dentist. If you ask about, is there any cure? Obviously, if a disease is detected in its initial or early phase, it can be prevented. And if the disease is extremely advanced, the tissue and the bone affected or destroyed cannot be restored. This leads me to my next point, which is how can dental pyria be prevented? The following rescue tips can be adopted to avoid this disease. Brush every morning and night before sleeping for at least 2 to 3 minutes. Floss daily. Flossing is very important. Flossing should be done after toothbrushing, because brush, no matter how well you do it, they cannot go in between the teeth. So you need to floss daily. Use a toothbrush with soft bristles. Don't use hard bristles because they will abrade your teeth. Change your toothbrush at least every 3 to 4 months. Eat a healthy diet rich in calcium and vitamin C. Avoid cigarettes and chewing tobacco. Periodically get yourself checked from a doctor, and you must get your teeth cleaned at least twice a year from the dentist. There is a prevalent myth that scaling leads to problems in the teeth. Actually, it is just the opposite. Scaling helps to make your teeth healthy. So get scaling done at least twice a year. Remember that prevention today will be a key to avoiding dental pyria in the future. And finally, let's discuss the treatment option. So what is the treatment of pyria? Pyria can be treated by scaling or root planing. This is a thorough cleaning of teeth and gums. In this, plaque and tartar are cleaned from the top and bottom of the gums. This can cure pyria, but it is only helpful in the initial stages of pyria. Through surgery, In severe cases of periodontitis, the dentist needs to clean the severely damaged gums. After this, the gums are closed by stitches around the teeth and it is only done in a serious condition. Gingival grafting, if the gums have been badly affected, the gums from a healthy area will be removed and it will be stitched in the affected place. So at the end, let me summarize the important facts once again. Pyria is an oral condition occurring due to plaque buildup along gum lines. Bacteria are the main cause of pyria. These bacteria form plaque, then calculus, and it leads to destruction of even the bone if not treated. Smoking is harmful to health and also the main cause of pyria. Therefore, avoid smoking. Regular visit to your dentist help identify pyria at the early stages. You should visit your dentist every 6 months to maintain good oral hygiene. If you want any other information related to pyria, you can send us your questions by writing them in the comment box below. Well, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Allah Hafiz.